Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Our gathering song is number 389. Here I am, Lord. 389. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion in the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we call to mind our need for God's continued healing, mercy, and peace in our lives. Lord Jesus, you died to take away our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you rose again to bring new life to your people. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you call us to generosity of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the give you
Merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that, unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Kings. In those days, Elijah the prophet went to Zarephath. As he arrived at the entrance of the city, a widow was gathering sticks there. He called out to her, "Please bring me a small cupful of water to drink." She left to get it, and he called out after her, "Please bring along a bit of bread." She answered, "As the Lord your God lives, I have nothing baked. There is only a handful of flour in my jar and a little oil in my jug. Just now, I was collecting a couple of sticks to go in and prepare something for myself and my son. When we have eaten it, we shall die." Elijah said to her, "Do not be afraid. Go and do as you propose. But first, make me a little cake and bring it to me. Then you can prepare something for yourself and your son. For the Lord, the God of Israel, says, 'The jar of flour shall not go empty, nor the jug of oil run dry, until the day when the Lord sends rain upon the earth.'" She left and did as Elijah had said. She was able to eat for a year, and he and her son as well. The jar of flour did not go empty, nor the jug of oil run dry, as the Lord had foretold through Elijah. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm can be found on page 224.
Justice to the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets captives free. Praise but the way of the wicked he thwarts. The Lord shall reign forever, your God, O Zion, through the generations. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, my soul.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Christ did not enter into a sanctuary made by hands, a copy of the true one, but heaven itself, that he might now appear before God on our behalf. Not that he might offer himself repeatedly, as the high priest enters each year into the sanctuary with blood that is not his own. If that were so, he would have had to suffer repeatedly from the foundation of the world. But now, once for all, he has appeared at the end of the ages to take away sin by his sacrifice. Just as it is appointed that human beings die once, and after this the judgment, so also Christ, offered once to take away the sins of many, will appear a second time, not to take away sin, but to bring salvation to those who eagerly await him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. In the course of his teaching, Jesus said to the crowds, "Beware of the scribes, who like to go around in long robes and accept greetings in the marketplaces, seats of honor in the synagogues, places of honor at banquets. They devour the houses of widows and, as a pretext, recite lengthy prayers. They will receive a very severe condemnation." He sat down opposite the treasury and observed how the crowd put money into the treasury. Many rich people put in large sums. But a poor widow also came and put two small coins worth a few cents. Calling his disciples to himself, he said to them, "Amen, I say to you, this poor widow put in more than all the other contributors to the treasury. For they have all contributed from their surplus wealth, but she, from her poverty, has contributed all she had, her whole livelihood." The Gospel of the Lord. There is never a time when God will be outdone in generosity. There is never a time where he will limit his love. Frankly, it's one thing that God can't do and still be God. By his very nature, the heart of which is his spirit, is a constant outpouring, outflowing of a love that is creative, life-giving, and eternal. All his creation, the moon, the stars, the sun, the creatures, you and I, are the recipients of that constant flow of unending, unconditional regard. If it ever stopped even for a moment, we would go into oblivion. Every breath is a gift. Every moment is passionate love. You and I are called not only to be the vessels of that love, but like any vessel, we're meant to pour that out onto all that we see, our brothers and sisters, creation, all of it. And like a vessel, when we are emptied, it is God who refills it. To live this day by day is to live both the will of God and to welcome in the kingdom of God, which is God's vision, God's idea of what all of this is supposed to be. The implications are amazing, staggering. Holiness is supposed to be the rule, not the exception. Our glory is not finery that can be made by human hands. Our glory is the very glory of God, and his glory is to be our outer skin. We're to reflect that glory. And we've been so long without it and so far from it that we've forgotten completely. We've come to accept the commonness of this creation as our end. Far from it. This is just the beginning. And we are called being vessels of that spirit, to continually grow into that holiness. That's what he said to Moses. I am the Lord. Walk with me and be perfect, for I am holy. We forget that. And failing to see the holiness in ourselves,
failing to see that image of God that we are, we don't see it in one another. And so we have envy, and we have jealousy, and we have hatred. And we have war. And the terrible price of war. And the image that we are is destroyed. It's time for humankind to wake up, to accept who and what we are, not what we think we are, not what other people with distorted vision say we are, but who God Himself calls us to be by name, pouring into us as vessels His own Spirit of life and love. We are consecrated vessels. You were baptized into His death and resurrection. You were anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, confirmation. You have been fed over and over again at this table and tables like it throughout the world with the very body and blood of Christ Himself, so that that presence is renewed regularly, often. How quickly we forget. So today, like the widow of Zarephath, who was called upon to believe, and whose belief was rewarded with food unending, so we are called upon, invited, if you will, to not only be the recipient of that unending love, to truly be the vessel to pour that gift out onto a world that today is hurting, in darkness, and cynical. It was no joke when Jesus said, "You are the light of the world. You are the salt of the earth that gives season and savor to the insipid. You are the city on the mountaintop. The glory of God shines out from you, day and night, without cease. You are His image. The next time you look into a mirror, recognize it. The next time you look into the eyes of your beloved, recognize it. Acknowledge it. And for God's sake and your own, embrace it. In so doing, like Mary, we incarnate that word again and again. We become that living word. And that word has no end. So like Elijah and the widow, like the people of Paul's time, we too are called to that same life and light. May God give us the strength to embrace it, the courage to carry it, and the love to share it, until the words that He spoke come true in time and eternity. Your kingdom come, Your will be done, on earth and in us as in heaven. We acknowledge our belief in this loving God in the words of the Creed of Nicaea. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son, the glory of the Lord, who is one of us. I believe in one holy Catholic Church, I confess one baptism of the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Out of our want, we humbly offer our prayers to the Lord, no matter how insignificant they may seem, trusting that God will respond to even the smallest need.
For the church, that like the widows in today's readings, we may respond with generosity and hospitality beyond measure to the needs of others, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That those who were elected to public office this past week may govern with justice and serve with integrity. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That Vivian Jo Vandehei's baptism remind us to respect human life from the moment of conception. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That every veteran of our nation's armed forces feel truly and appropriately honored by the attention and appreciation of their fellow citizens. Let no one feel forgotten or neglected. Let every man and woman, young or old, feel the deep and enduring gratitude of our nation. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for blessings upon all married couples, especially Richard and Jenny Hutkevich, celebrating their 59th wedding anniversary. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For the dead who long for the company of Mary and of all the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Generous God, you have taught us how to give and how to share. Help us to imitate your generosity as you grant our needs and those of our brothers and sisters who are in need. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. The song during the preparation of gifts is number 326, The Body of Christ, 326.
Broken and blessed, miracle of the greatest of love.
receive, we remember, believe, and share so that others may live. Amen, amen. We are healed by the bread of life. Amen, amen. We are one in the body of Christ. We are one in the body of
Brothers and sisters, pray that this our sacrifice be acceptable to God our Father, the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of the name, for our good and the good of all the Church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Yes.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, for when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity may the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the Church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, and he said the blessing, and he broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. He gave you thanks, and he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, David, our bishop, with all bishops, priests, deacons, dedicated religious, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her devoted husband, with the apostles, the martyrs, our Holy Father Francis, Holy Mother Claire, Saints Casimir and Stanislaus and Benedict, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. at the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Share that gift of peace with one another. Peace to you, Mary.
Peace be with you, Father.
And with you. Thank you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are they called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Amen. Body of Christ.
Amen. Body of Christ.
The 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 body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Our song during communion is number 408. These alone are enough. 408.
Sorry, I put up the wrong number.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Take my heart, O Lord. Take my hopes and dreams. Take my mind with all its plans and schemes. Give me nothing more than your love.
Body of Christ.
Alone.
Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Litany of Announcements. We are offering season 4 of The Chosen at ABVM on Tuesday nights. Everyone is welcome to attend one or all the sessions. There are schedules by the entrances of the church for you to pick up on your way out. Tuesday is our first joint finance council meeting of all three of our parish families at St. Casimir Church at 6:30 p.m. All interested parishioners are always welcome to attend. If you had a loved one remembered at our All Souls Day Mass on November 2nd, the candle that was lit in their honor is available at the front exit of the church for you to take home. We celebrated the funeral mass today for Patrick Gwitt. We also received word that Sylvia Adamski has died. Sylvia's funeral will be Saturday, December 7th. Please check the Marnocha Funeral Home website for complete details. We extend our sympathy and prayerful support to the Gwitt and Adamski families. Eternal rest grant unto Pat and Sylvia, O Lord. May they rest in peace. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Richard and Jenny Chodkiewicz are celebrating their 59th anniversary today. Unfortunately, Jenny's sick. So take a moment, let's pray for her and pray for Richard as they continue to persevere in God's grace and in their love for one another. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Richard, congratulations. On behalf of everyone here, give your bride a kiss for us. Let me see. It's always there until you don't have it. If there are any veterans here tonight, I would ask that you remain standing and that everyone would extend their right hand toward them in blessing. Almighty loving God, we honor our veterans, worthy men and women, who gave their best when they were called upon to serve and protect their country. We pray that you will bless them, Lord, for their unselfish service to preserve our freedoms, our safety, and our country's heritage for all of us. Bless them abundantly for the hardships they faced for the sacrifices they made. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for your service. Thanks can never be measured for all that you have given and that you continue to give. God bless you as you bless us. Guess what? It's over. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our celebration here is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Our sending forth song is not in your hymnal, but we'll know it by heart. God bless America.
To the oceans, white with foam.